This week, we talk about that PlayStation 5, we got some Amazon news, more specifically an RIP, and we got some Apple stuff that may not be so good for Apple. And of course, we got more as we, together, as a people, check it out. Welcome to another sensational Saturday. This is Mike, and this is Mike Techs It Out, where I bring you the tech news. And the Mike Techs It Out table is gone this week. I decided to go with a simpler setup, which is me in front of the camera, you know, doing my best thing. And there might be a lot of moisture right now because it's hot. The news is hot this week, and I'm hot because my AC is not working. So if I start sweating like halfway through the video, and it's like pouring down, you know why. But I'm still here for you to bring you the tech news. But seriously though, if I start sweating, I might need you to break me out. Kind of like a jailbreak, but for my house. And speaking of jailbreaks, it came out this week that there's a new jailbreak that's out for iPhone that even works for the current versions of iOS with the current phones. It's crazy. Like, when has jailbreaking been a thing? Like, since they've introduced like all the stuff that people wanted, like, you know, customizable backgrounds and widgets, kind of have widgets. Since they started introducing that stuff, I just don't hear a lot about jailbreaks anymore. I remember jailbreaking my first iPhone because that was back when it was AT&T exclusive, and I just jailbroke it so I could unlock it so I could use it on T-Mobile. And that was my main reason for jailbreaking. I really didn't get heavily into a lot of the other stuff that people were doing. I had my custom background because that was the thing that I wanted. And I think I did try an emulator or two, but that was pretty much it. Like, that was my whole experience with the jailbreak. I did it, it was cool, but I don't know what a reason would be in 2020 to jailbreak an iPhone. Because in reality, if you wanted that additional functionality from the iPhone, whatever you're trying to do, you probably could just buy like a high-end Android phone and do the same thing with a lot less work. And it'll probably be fixed soon anyway. So it is what it is, but it happened. iPhone jailbreak is back. It's like Return of the Mac. I bet Tim Cook right now is like, oh, come on, yeah. That was the best I could do on short notice, okay? I wasn't warmed up. Let's just move on to the next story. And this story, unfortunately, is a very sad story. So Amazon, they got an RIP, the Echo Look. And I know all of you love that device. It used computational photography to take pictures of your outfits and learn, you know, what you like so you can help pick them out. But it's going to stop functioning in July this year. They're discontinuing it. They're RIPing it completely. I know everyone's sad. I know everyone knows what it is. You guys know. Oh, no one knows what that is. But yeah, if you don't remember this thing or never heard of it, it kind of looked like a camera and a smart doorbell combined. I think it had like lights on it. It was an Echo that literally was designed to take pictures or short videos of you, and then you could go into this app and it would help you pick out your outfit or see how you look in certain outfits. It was really dumb. It was a dumb product. And it was $200. And I do feel bad for people that bought it, and now, because I think it just came out in 2017, well, not just came out, you know, in tech world, that's ancient. But it's still something that you spent $200 on 3 years ago, possibly. And now it's just gonna be completely useless. I wonder if it'll still function as an Echo. I wonder if they're just taking out like the fashion stuff. Cause then at least you still have like a $25 product, cause it's pretty much, you know, like an Echo Dot. But if it doesn't even do that, then it's really gonna be sad for those people. I feel bad for them. Truly feel bad for them. And really the only reason I say that it's dumb is not that the premise was dumb, but it's like they already have these Echoes, like the Echo Show. They have the mini one. They have all these Echo shows that already have a camera on it. And I don't think that that camera on the Echo Look was that much better than those cameras. So I feel like you could have just baked this into one of your existing video Echo products that already had a camera. And then it would have just been a whole thing. Instead of making this separate thing that has no screen, and you have to use a phone to even look at yourself with the footage. It literally didn't make any sense. It was a bad product. It's an RIP. And let's just hope it never comes back. We don't need no Halloween resurrection or nothing like that for the Echo Look. Let's just look away as it takes its final breath. Woo! Speaking of last breath, you know a place where it's hard to catch your breath because it's so hot? My house. And also Arizona. Speaking of Arizona, they're suing Google because they feel like they misled customers into giving up their data by making it difficult to opt out of it and just straight up lying about it. At least that's what the Attorney General is claiming. So, yep, Google is going back to court again for privacy stuff. And they're not the only company. Every major company that's involved in these new ways of communications, that have these smart speakers, that have these smartphone assistants, they've all done shady stuff with the information. I think Google's thing specifically is them collecting so much information and kind of doing it in shady ways, but it's definitely not the first time that they've been in hot water for it. Probably won't be the last time. And I know Google's been trying to reverse course on that and be like, you know, we're upfront and transparent. And I'm like, nobody believes you at this point. Like, you've got too big. You got too powerful. We was all having fun for a long time. We was having fun doing Google searches. We were like, oh, chia pets, tacos. We were just searching everything. And now we gave them all the data. They know everything about us. They know all of our interests, all the weird stuff. They know everything. The point is, aside from the search engine and of course YouTube, I don't use too many Google products. Like, I don't use their phones. So people in the comments that use Android, let me know how easy or difficult it is to opt out of location tracking for Google apps like Maps, Mail, etc. Because I'm just curious about it myself. I don't know how I feel about it, but we'll see what happens with this lawsuit. I know the last two stories, they didn't have enough enjoyment, but I'm here to bring your enjoyment to the max, like HBO Max that launched this week. So HBO Max is basically HBO, all the Warner services in one. People have been thirsty for it, and now everybody has access to it, unless you're on like a Fire Stick or Roku, or a lot of those, you know, popular streaming devices that are cheap and that a lot of people have. It's on Apple TV though. I'm good. Except for in my bedroom where I have a Roku. And in this room where we have a Roku. But you know what? 2 out of 4 rooms is not bad. Yes, HBO Max came out. I don't know how you feel about it. I like it so far. I mean, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air is up there. That's all, like, I was already sold. Like, when you said that's up there, I'm like, okay, just sign me up. I've been enjoying it so far. I did read some articles about how it's a mess and kind of stuff is just everywhere. I'm like, oh well, I'm just gonna watch the things that I wanna watch and I'm enjoying the things that are up there. That's all I got to say about it personally. But as far as their relationship with Amazon, now, Amazon's like, yo, we ain't putting you on the Fire Stick. You know why? Because we got people on our service that are subscribed to HBO and you're not offering them Max for free. Like, you're not offering them the extended service like you are with some of the cable companies. So until you do that, you ain't coming on our platform. And then Roku's like, oh, we're, you know, we're just trying to be cordial, but we haven't reached an agreement with HBO. So, you know, we're still working. Okay, so the money ain't right. The money ain't right. All you had to say was the money ain't right. That's all you had to say, Roku. You didn't have to go into this whole elaborate thing. Amazon put them on blast, but we all know Amazon's a little bit ratchet. So Amazon, of course, is gonna put them on blast and be like, look, we ain't offering the service to our customers for free, so you ain't gonna be on our platform at all. Rat tat 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 tat, that's the way it is. Amazon's argument's fair. I don't know what's going on behind the scenes with Roku, how much money they want, or HBO wants, or whoever. Warner, AT&T, whoever owns, you know what? It's been so many parent companies, I forget who owns all of it. I think it's AT&T. Anyway, it's just not a great start to launch and then not be available on two of the biggest streaming devices that a lot of people have in their living room. It's like if you sign up for HBO Max and I'm like, okay, let me go download it on my TV. It's not there. It's not there because these big companies can't reach an agreement. I think it could possibly hurt their launch numbers. Hopefully they'll work out something soon because I really would like to personally have it on Roku because that is in 2 out of the 4 rooms in our house. That's in my bedroom. So we do watch a lot of stuff when we go to sleep. So it'd be nice to just have it there. Hopefully they get this worked out. If you tried HBO Max, let me know what you think. So in our final story, we got some brief PS5 news. So Sony announced on June 4th that they're gonna do, it's probably gonna be about an hour long, but it's gonna be showing off the games that are gonna be coming out on PS5. I didn't hear anything about how much of it's gonna be gameplay because we all know that, you know, Microsoft had that whole thing where they had the gameplay and it was like 2 seconds in like a 30-minute video. So I'm expecting it to be like E3 style where you might see snippets of gameplay, but it's mostly gonna be trailers to kind of educate you about the game with pre-rendered cinematics. I don't expect to see that much gameplay. If you want me to be honest about it, I didn't even expect to see that much gameplay from the Microsoft stuff. That's why I didn't even notice it when people were going like bananas online. I mean, the dude did hype it up at the beginning and he was like we listen to the interwebs, so we're gonna have gameplay. That's such a stupid thing to say. Just don't, they shouldn't have ever said that and it would've been okay. But I'm curious to see what Sony's got game-wise. Of course, we still haven't seen the system itself yet, and considering that this controller looks kind of like a spaceship, I'm expecting for Scotty just to come and beam me up right away as soon as I see it. I'm excited to see what Sony's got. They've been dripping out the information a little bit more slowly than Microsoft. Microsoft just got out there. We didn't have the box. We seen inside, outside. Tops, we didn't see the coolers. They're sending people x-rays. I don't know what's going on with Microsoft. They're just trying to get out there and get as much information out there, where Sony has been a little bit more strategic. All joking aside about the design, I really hope that it is something different. Especially with Microsoft kind of doing a similar design to what they did last time. It'd just be interesting to have three different looking consoles, because the Switch is a whole different thing too. So it would be unique to have three distinct looking consoles in the same space. But I'm gonna have to check out that video on Thursday and let y'all know how I feel. But until then, I'll be back on Tuesday for sure with more Mike Texted Out. Just wait until you get your eyes on what I got. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure to tell a friend, tell a coworker, like, share, and subscribe, and always do at least two things at the same time.